Dear students, in this video I am going to discuss about torsion of a cylinder. Torsion means twist. A long body which is twisted around its length as an axis is said to be under torsion. So here let us consider a long cylindrical rod of length L. So the length of this cylindrical rod is L and radius capital R. So the radius of this cylinder, that is capital R, which is rigidly fixed at this particular point. It is fixed on top or the upper end, and let OO dash be its axis. The cylindrical rod is imagined to be made up of thin concentric hollow cylindrical layers, each of thickness dr. So the thickness of this small layer, cylindrical layer, is dr. If the rod is twisted, so if it is twisted like this in this direction, the concentric layers of the cylinder will slide one over the other. So this moment, that is known, is zero on the top end, and it gradually increases as we go down, because on the top side it is fixed and we just give the rotations on the bottom side. So what happens is the twisting is more here, and it becomes, no, it is zero on the tied end, on the top surface. So let us consider one concentric circular layer of radius R and thickness dr. So this particular layer, see here, you can see a point x, so which is fixed on the top surface, and the point b on the bottom. So what happens is when we twist the cylinder, see, the point b is going to shift to, so it moves to a new place, that is b dash. And this angle BX B dash, so that's equal to, denoted by phi, that's the angle of shear, or the angle of twist here. So angle of shear, that is phi in this case. Since this phi is small, so this BB dash, that's equal to this length into the angle subtended, so that's equal to phi. So I can write BB dash, so that's equal to L phi. Now see angle BO dash B dash, so that is denoted by theta. Then this arc length BB dash, so that's equal to, so this radius, that's small r into theta. So BB dash, so that's equal to R into theta. So we have, see, the left hand side of the equation is same. So I can write L phi, that's equal to R theta, or phi, that's equal to R theta by L. So let this be equation number one. So we are going to find an expression for the couple per unit twist. So see, the cross sectional area of this small cylinder, that is, we are going to find out what's the cross sectional area of this circular part. So that is 2 pi r dr, that is a cross sectional area, and F is the shearing force. Then the shearing stress is denoted by T. So T is given by shearing stress, so that is force divided by area. So force divided by area, so that's equal to 2 pi r dr. And the shearing force F, so from this relation, that's equal to 2 pi r dr into T. So cross multiplication. So let this be equation number 2. Yes, so rigidity modulus eta, so that's given by shearing stress divided by shearing strain. So that is eta, so that's equal to shearing stress is T divided by phi, that is the shearing strain. So from this relation we have, this implies T is equal to eta phi. So that's equal to eta into phi. So from the first equation, that is equal to r theta divided by L. So from our second equation, see, we have, so equation second, so that says force F, so that's equal to T into 2 pi r into dr. Now substitute the values. So T is this. So eta r theta divided by L into 2 pi r into dr. So therefore force F, that's equal to 2 pi eta r into r, so r square theta divided by L into dr. So this is the expression for the force. Now the moment of the force about the axis O dash, so that's equal to force into the distance, so that is equal to 2 pi eta theta, just multiply this by r, so you will get r cube divided by L into dr. So this is a moment of the force for one layer of the cylinder. So for the entire cylinder, the twisting couple for the entire cylinder, so that is a twisting couple acting on the entire cylinder, so that's given by, so we have to integrate this, whatever we have found is for one such layer of the cylinder, so that's equal to r is equal to 0, that is from the center till the radius of the cylinder capital R, integrate 2 pi eta theta divided by L into r cube into dr. So if you integrate, this will be 2 pi eta theta divided by L, so r to the power 4 divided by 4 within the limit 0 to capital R. So if you substitute, you will get, so this is equal to once, so here twice, and this will be pi eta theta divided by 2 L into r to the power 4. So this is the twisting couple acting on the entire cylinder, pi eta theta r power 4 divided by 2 L. So the couple per unit twist, to find this we have to divide this by the angle theta, so that's equal to pi eta into r power 4 divided by 2 L. So this is the expression for the couple per unit twist. Yeah, now we'll discuss about torsional pendulum. So anyhow, you have conducted this experiment in the lab, so you know that a torsional pendulum, it consists, see, a rigid body is being suspended by means of a wire, and it's just fixed on the top side, and it undergoes oscillations in the horizontal plane. So such a system is called a torsional pendulum, and the time period of which is given by T is equal to 2 pi into root of I by C, where I is the moment of inertia, C is the couple per unit twist. And so what's the application of this particular experiment? So as you have already conducted the experiment, and that by using this particular experiment, we can find the moment of inertia of any regular body. So what we do is, if we have some regular bodies and find out what's the time period for that, and if you find what's the value of I by T square, then if you have an irregular body, you can definitely find out what's the moment of inertia of the irregular body. So that's one of the application of this experiment. And the second one is to find the rigidity modulus of a material. So if the body is suspended by means of a wire, you can find out what's the moment of inertia, what's the rigidity modulus of the given wire, okay, by using this particular experiment. So this is the application of the torsional pendulum experiment. So this is a very important topic.